Hey guys, what's up? A lot of you guys have been hitting me up asking about what my life is like now post-operation of my total colectomy, and what all has changed, what hasn't changed, is anything different? Just basically everything A to Z with it. And so I wrote down a few things just to touch on, and we'll go from there. So the first thing that I immediately went through was the getting used to the frequency of going to the bathroom. Like, because I ended up having the surgery because my colon stopped working, so I wasn't having bowel movements anymore. So I went from like not having any bowel movements ever to like back to back to back to back to back to back. And so right after I had my surgery, I was in the hospital for 15 days. And those were the worst 2 weeks ever. I shit on myself more than I care to admit. I thought my life was over because of that particular fact. I had to wear like adult diapers for a while. It was good times. But you know, it is what it is. And you, some of you guys, if you haven't had the surgery, like you might do what I did, because sometimes when I would be like walking or trying to get back into my exercising, I would go have like a, I guess like a shart, and not know it, or still be like leaking like mucus, and then it was just like a mess. So I got these Depends active wear, and I would wear those whenever I was going out or going to be moving around a lot. And that saved me a lot of time. So that's a point that I wanted to make sure that I got to you guys. Let's see. Oh, after having the surgery, my butt was like numb for a little while. It was just like kind of weird feeling. Like I knew it was there, you know, but I would sit on the toilet to go to the bathroom and then kind of be like, am I going? You know? Like if I did like the muscles, I could like feel that, and then it would still be like a little bit sore. And they told me for like the first month and a half to not try to try to not bear down like when having a bowel movement. But it's like it goes against your natural reflex, your natural body's response to want to do when you're having a bowel movement. But I mean, it was sore, but it wasn't bad. It wasn't as bad as I was expecting it to be. It didn't feel like I was getting ripped apart from the inside every time I went to the bathroom, because mostly it was like incredibly mushy or like just watery consistency. And sorry for the details, but that's just how it is and what something that you'll have to adapt to having. Like I said, for me, I thought it was, I was in like catastrophe mode. I thought it was a crisis. Because I wasn't having any bowel movements before, and they definitely weren't like frequently liquidy, so I was like, why is this even happening to me? So that, and then butt barrier, that's not what it's called, it's moisture barrier, by Coloplast. I use that stuff religiously because of the frequency of going to the bathroom, and it kind of just helps to not make things so raw and sensitive, you know, when you're going to the bathroom all the time and wiping. If you can have a bowel movement and then dab with regular toilet paper and then get some, I call them booty wipes, but you get some booty wipes that are like flushable and just go behind and wipe with it, it's so much easier on your butt than using regular toilet paper, you know, and just being, it's terrible. It'll tear your butt up, and then every single time after that, going to the bathroom, it's gonna burn. Just save yourself some time and a whole lot of pain by getting you some moisture barrier. The kind that I use is clear, and I always pack like a to-go bag. I always have a to-go bag with moisture barrier, a pair of those active Depends, a change of underwear, regular underwear, booty wipes, and panty liners. And all those just because it's always, I can't go to the bathroom. I went to the bathroom one time at my friend's house and I quickly realized, I was like, I have messed up so bad because they didn't have booty wipes and they had like some hard ass toilet paper and it was just, I was like, I gotta go. So save yourself and your butt some hardship and just pack you some supplies. It's a headache. I had to get a bigger bag purse to carry around just for that purpose. I carry a backpack in my car with everything. But really, in general, aside from steaming all my vegetables so they're soft and soggy, and just kind of trying to watch what I eat, things that don't have try to eat things that don't have seeds in them or like a stringy texture because with no colon, it doesn't break it down. And it causes a lot of like upset stomach symptoms. But really that and just trying to stay hydrated, because the frequency of going to the bathroom mixed with having them be mostly liquid bowel movements, it's like a cycle of like, okay, well, I'm gonna stay hydrated, and then you're going to the bathroom so much, and then you get dehydrated again. I haven't found that medium yet. So that's still something, almost 3 years later that I'm still working at, because I get dehydrated frequently. But other than that, everything's pretty much kind of the same way it was before, except I go to the bathroom now. And that's really it. I'm not having like any like weird butt pains, or anything like that. Somebody asked me that, like, do you have butt pain? Sometimes though, like, but only when I'm like on my period. That's the only time that I'll have some achy pains. That's really about it, guys. And if you have any other questions, hit me up. Feel free to leave a comment here if you want to know anything else, or if I didn't cover something that you want to know or you have questions about. Feel free to hit me up. Most of you guys got in contact with me on Instagram, I think. Stacia Jeanette is my Instagram name. I will put that in the description as well. But if you do not, I'll talk to you guys soon. Thanks.